In this video, we'll be demonstrating how to perform an operational check, how to defibrillate, perform synchronized cardioversion, and do transcutaneous pacing or TCP using a Philips HeartStart Intrepid defibrillator. As part of your checks on the Philips Intrepid defibrillator, always make sure that the check mark is blinking. If you see a cross in this area, make sure that the device is plugged in and make sure that your therapy cable is connected properly. Let's review how to perform an operational check. Make sure you connect your therapy cable to your test load. Switch the device on into monitor mode. Wait for the device to boot up. Press on your menu button. Scroll down until Other and select Operational Check. It will ask run operational check. I will select that. It will ask me exit clinical mode. I will select yes. And follow now the commands on the screen. Select 170 joules. It asks me to turn the button to 150 and press charge. Press shock button. Did you hear shock delivered? Yes. Press the sync button and release. It tells me operational check pass, check printed report. At this point, we can click exit operational check. It asks me stop printing. For this purpose, I will say yes. And the device will reboot back into clinical mode. Next step, switch off the device. And the device is ready for patient care. During cardiac arrest management and you want to defibrillate, ensure to attach your multifunction pads as per the manufacturer's recommendation. Here we see ventricular fibrillation and immediate defibrillation is indicated. We'll put a device to 150 joules as per the recommendation from the manufacturer. We'll press charge. Once the machine is fully charged, everybody clear.
Shock delivered.
And immediately
begin CPR.
Begin high quality CPR. Here we see ventricular tachycardia with a pulse on the monitor. The patient is having serious signs and symptoms, decreased level of consciousness, chest discomfort, shortness of breath, and the patient is hypotensive. So synchronized cardioversion is indicated. We can consider pain relief and sedation if needed. We'll select 100 joules. As per the recommendation from the manufacturer, we'll press the sync button. We'll press charge. Once the machine is fully charged, press and hold the shock button.
Shock delivered.
And immediately reanalyze the ECG and repeat the patient's vital signs. Here we see a sinus bradycardia with serious signs and symptoms. The patient has shortness of breath, decreased level of consciousness, and the patient is hypertensive. The patient did not respond to atropine, and transcutaneous pacing or TCP is indicated. Ensure to attach your pads and your leads. I'll put the device immediately into pacer mode. I will set a rate to 70. I'll click on output. I will decrease it to the lowest available and I will hit start pacing. I will slowly increase my output until I achieve capture. We can see the pacing spikes on the screen. Here we have a pacing spike immediately followed by a white QRS. So we've achieved capture. I want to go slightly higher to 80 to create a buffer. Check your patient's pulse and repeat vital signs.